Hello, hello, hello. So, this is not a planner video. This is, I'm going to unbox some stuff for you. I recently discovered Stampin' Up! And I'm like, oh my god, there is so much stuff I want. I was lucky enough, if I can find the birdie book. I was lucky enough for someone to recently send me the catalogue, which is going to go live in September. And quite frankly, I'm too bloody scared to look in it. So I'm, yeah. I went on to a couple of groups on Facebook and on eBay, and I got a couple of good deals. Now, I have never used Stampin' Up! Products before, so this is a total noob going in on this, okay? I ordered a punch and stamp set. This came from a lovely lady on a Facebook group. She gave me quite a good deal on it. And this is a scalloped tag topper punch. And I got that for an absolute steal on eBay, which I am so, so pleased about. So we're going to open these up and we're going to have a little look, and you're going to get a noob's first impression. Okay, so let's get to it. These are just like old post-it notes so that you guys can't see my address, because, you know, I don't want you to see it. Unless you're going to send me stuff, in which case, you know, PM me and I'll give you my address. So let's start with this one. Bubble wrap, you know, who doesn't love a bit of bubble wrap? Did I hear right that they're like getting rid of bubble wrap? That doesn't seem fair, does it? You know, everybody likes playing with bubble wrap. Rotten sods. Okay, so that's the tag topper. Okay, when you punch it, you get this at the top. Okay, it makes this nice shape and you get this little hole in it. I know absolutely nothing about this. I understand you have to... Oh, okay, right. Oh, okay. For some reason I was expecting it to open that way. But it hasn't, it's opened that way. Like that. Crikey, that's strong. That is really strong. That's the punch bit in there. Now, I have pre-torn off some paper. I understand it takes 2-inch paper strips. Mine are just a little bit over. So, oh, it goes in quite a way. So you go in until it stops and then you go. Ooh, what a satisfying sound. Look! How cool is that? That is absolutely freaking awesome. I love how neatly that has... See, there is no way in hell I could cut something this neat. See, I have a billion and one ideas. One of my, I suppose you would say my online friends, Michelle, who is from Ugly Bug Plans, and she and her husband made Poppins. She has one of these, and this is entirely her fault that I have this, because she did this lovely video on making tags using watercolour paper, and they are adorable, and I would really like to do that this year for Christmas and birthdays. So this is what it looks like from underneath. Anyway, you can see there's the paper sliding in. You just slide it in basically until it stops. Oh, there's my cutouts, look. And then you just... Look how smooth that is. Then that all falls out. You can see it sticking up there. It doesn't feel particularly sharp, so which means it'd be quite safe when it's closed. I have a 3-year-old, so I have to think about things like that. And then, yeah, it's just, it's in there. And then you just pull it out, and you've got a fabulous little tag. That is cool. That is cool. I am impressed with that. I really, really like that. Yeah, really like that. So yeah, so I assume you just close it and slide it, and it makes it quite flat. So to give you an idea of how big this thing is, it is on my board just shy of 6 inches. Okay, it's about 5.5 inches long. All right, and it is just under 3.5 inches wide. Okay, and depth is just over 1.25 inches. Okay, if you want that in centimeters, that is, because you know some people don't like converting, just over 14 centimeters long. Eight and a half centimeters wide and 3.2 centimeters or 32 millimeters deep. I couldn't tell you how much it weighs. I'm not very good at estimating that kind of thing. It's sturdy. It's heavy. It feels, well, it's not heavy, but it's quite sturdy. There you go. It says there. Don't know how well you can see that because my camera doesn't have a focus. Says there's the Stampin' Up! Logo, and then I think that's the pat number underneath there, and that's it, that's all that's on there. So there's no extra crap. Sorry about the buzzing, that's my phone. There's no extra crap, there's no bells, whistles, frills, or anything like that. Fab little tool, and it makes little gift tags. And that, do you know what, dudes? Check out, search on YouTube for Stampin' Up! Scallop tag topper punch. The things you can make with just this is incredible. There are some fantastic videos out there. I've saved a load of them because I am, yeah, really looking forward to having a go. But yeah, I like that. That's cool. I have ideas on what I'm going to do with that. So now we're going to get on to the other fun stuff. Right, let's have a look. Feel cringe while I mess around with this bloody great sharp knife. That's the address bit out the way. Okie dokie. Now, I do have some stamps, but I don't tend to use them because I never really know what to do with them, and I don't have a lot of inks either. But I think that's going to be something that's going to have to change soon, because I want to use more mixed media in my bullet journal to make it more of like an art journal. So yeah, hence, oh, giant bubble wrap. Hey, we're on a roll here, guys. We've got all the bubble wrap in the world. Look, big fat giant wrap, lovely. And then little bitty bitty weird about, except she stuck tape on it. I'm all for repurposing. See, if I can get multiple uses out of bubble wrap, I bloody well will. And if I can't, I take it to my local reptile shop because they use it to wrap frozen mice in so that they don't defrost when I bring them home to feed my snakes. So you know, it goes roundabouts. So as you might be able to tell, this is a stamp and punch set. This is a bubble wrap bag. How cool is that? See, I get so excited about bubble wrap. So this is what I have. Isn't that fab? And I have matching stamps. How absolutely groovy is that? I'm going to move my phone because, quite frankly, it's hacking me off now. That can go over there. So, do these work in the same way? Oh, yeah, these work in exactly the same way. So, just put my knife away. No, I'm going to stamp them first and then have a play. So I've got a nice little, this one's called a Petite Petals. And you get 6 different stamps with it. And they come in here. Oh, look at that. Oh, I see. That's there to tell you what each one is. Looks like the previous owner might have tried to peel these off. So what's just... Oh, I see. Oh, they just stick on. Okay. To assemble clear mount stamps, remove the image from the rubber sheet, remove the backing from the foam. You can use as is, or you can adhere the label to the foam so you can see image on back of stamp. So what, I can stick these things... Oh, I see. I think I can stick those on... Can I stick them straight on the back of those? I think, yeah, that looks like that's what the previous person did. Oh, well, I might just do that. Those are pretty. I like those a lot. They're not in the order that they are on the case though, which kind of freaks me out, so I would have to change that. So that's that one. And then on this one, these are pansies. And again, there you go, that's what you get inside. So it looks like she didn't use a block, which, you know, I know you'd need. I have a couple of acrylic blocks because I have some cheap Hobbycraft stamps. That one, for example, is a ball of yarn. It looks like that is just big enough for one of these stamps. And this is a... two and a half inch by 1.5 inch, I suppose. Or 4 centimetres by 7.5 centimetres. Okay. So, do I use them without the block then? Well, that's what I'm going to have a go at doing, okay? And if I'm doing it wrong, you guys can tell me, okay? And say, like, you know, Sam, you're fucking it up, mate. You're doing it wrong. So, yeah. Okay, I really want to have a go with this one because I really like this. This was, like, the one that really grabbed my attention. So, we are going to do that flower. And then we're going to see if we can stamp it. So... You know, what other colour are we going to use other than purple? Okay, and if as well, you know, I shouldn't use this ink with these stamps, tell me, and you know, I won't ever do it again, but let's have a go, you know, let's have a play. I think it's that one that I want, so I'll just pull it out. That fit on there? Yeah, that fit on there. It's been a while since I've used these inks, so I hope they're still okay. Also, you know, what's the best way to clean these rubber stamps, if you know? I'm really hoping that Michelle, who's a Stamping Up demonstrator, is going to be able to answer that. Each petal is ever so slightly different as well. Okay, so there we go. It's inked. And let's see what we get. I suppose using a block would give me more room to put, you know, get a hold of it and all that lot. Wow, look at that, isn't that gorgeous? Oh, that's really, 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 really pretty. Okay, so. Are the outer edges all the same? Do you think? See, that bit there is ever so slightly different from all of these. So does that mean I have to stamp a certain... Now, I remember hearing something online that this petal has like an extra little bit on there, and if I'm right, it's that petal there. So it's just a little bit too big to go in the punch. How frustrating is that? Okay, I'm going to have to tear the paper a little bit to get the paper in. So that'll be something I'll have to look out for. Oh, this could be quite a... Is there a trick to lining these up, you know? Or is it just a case of... When you think you're there, go for it. Look at that. How cool is that? That is awesome. That is really awesome. So I'm going to put that to one side. And I'm also going to pull out. I have a nice pink one as well. Let's do a couple, shall we? Do that one. Right, nice and inked. I think this will actually fit on here. Oh, that looks really good as well. These stamp so clearly, okay? I mean, I'm used to these clear stamps and they look quite shit sometimes, to be perfectly honest. The lines on these are really, really nice. I suppose it's just my inexperience that makes them look a bit crap. But there you go. Right, is there a special one for these, or do you think, or do they just go in any old how? See, again, there seems to be an extra little crinkle on one of the petals on that one, but I don't know whether that is just me or... okay, so let's try it. That was a little bit more wonky because I didn't actually give myself enough time. But again, that has come out really, really nice. This is just on cheap copy paper, guys, okay? This isn't on, decent cardstock or anything like that. So, yeah, you know, but it's just, this is just me having a little play. I'm really pleased with those. I can see me having lots of fun. And I think next month my journal is going to be decorated with quite a lot of pretty little flowers. Yeah. So, there you go. I won't do the rest. You don't need to see all of them. They're all done in pretty much the same way, I expect. I'm really, really pleased with that. Good fun. Keep me quiet for a while anyway, won't it? Give me something to do. Hey, if you know the answers to my questions, like especially how do I clean these without damaging them, And you know, what's the best ink to use? This says multi-surface chalk ink. Excuse me. You know, are these okay to use, or should I get other inks? You know, I don't need stupid expensive ink, guys. I don't have any more money left, because after I bought all of this little lot, I then found out that we needed a new car seat, and I should not have really bought all of this. But there you go. There we go. Yeah, so you know, thanks very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this and had a laugh at my expense, because you know that's what I'm here for. But yeah, I'm really, really pleased with the goodies that I bought today. If you have any questions or anything you want to know, oh look, she kindly labelled them. She must have had them stocked in a drawer that way. That's quite cool. If you know any questions, comments, queries, leave them all down below. I'd be really, really pleased if you subscribed, and if you hit the bell, you'll be notified whenever I upload new content. Please, you know, give me a thumbs up if you just, even if I just made you giggle at any point, you know. Thanks very much for watching. Take it easy, guys. There'll be a new plan of video out soon. See you all. Bye.